Hello all, I'm candidate number one. When trying to figure out what I was going to do for the talent show, it was really hard because many of my talents take hours to complete. So today, I'll be presenting a PowerPoint as well as decorating cupcakes in front of you. All the cupcakes, frosting, and fondant have been made ahead of time. And I will, before I get to decorating, I'll present my PowerPoint. So here are some fall themed cupcakes that I created with some fondant leaves. Here are some bracelets that I created and designed. Here's a beaded necklace that I made and I'm wearing today. I made the chain and then I also made the little charm out of wires and beads. Here's some more fall themed cupcakes that I made with pumpkins and apples. And here's another necklace that I made out of chains. And a fun fact about this is actually the first necklace that I created and probably the most difficult necklace that I made. This is a cabin plaque that I hand painted, and I used it as cabin decor for our cabin. This is a portrait that I painted of my dog. She's a really good model. Here's some more fondant animals that I created. Here's a purple moon painting that I created, and I used acrylic paints for creating this one. This one's a watercolor painting that I created of a bridge. Someone near me lost someone, so I painted this card plaque as a gift to them to remember who they lost. Here's another chain necklace that I created. And then lastly, here's an edible dog birthday cake that I created for my dog. She definitely enjoyed it. Now I'm gonna get to decorating. So I'm gonna take some yellow fondant and I'm gonna roll into a ball. I'm using a bee as a reference, by the way. It's really hard because the fondant, we found out, melts underneath the stage lights. So I have to keep rolling it in powdered sugar to keep it from not melting. So I'm gonna take a little ball and then that's gonna be the bee's body. Then I'm gonna take some black fondant. I'm gonna just push this aside, and I'm gonna flatten this out to make the little bee stripes. Once I get it long enough, I'm gonna take this tool and then cut out some stripes. Then I'm going to take a sharper tool and then just carve those out. Once I have my little lines, I'm going to take the bee's body and then attach it to it. And then, once I have it attached, I'm going to roll it, and then hopefully it'll bond, because it's also really sticky and melting. Okay, then I'll take the second line, then I'm going to add to the bee's body. Because it's bouncing again. And then I'm going to create the little bee's wings by taking some white fondant. I'm going to take two equally sized pieces and I'm just going to roll them into a little bee shape. Then I'm going to take and add it to the bee's body. Then I'm going to take the other fondant. Create this exact same wing. body again. Now lastly, I'm gonna create the little eyes out of black. And take again two equal sized pieces. And then I'm gonna flatten them out on the surface. And then I'm gonna take a little bit of white fondant to use for the highlights of the eyes. And then I'm gonna add it to the mid-body. And then I'm gonna do the same exact thing for the other one. The cupcakes that I made here today, they're apple crisp, and they have a homemade filling inside of them. Apple filling that I made. Okay, then I'm finishing this one. Then I'll add to my B. And then I'll add it to my cupcake. I have right here. Very hard to stick it on because of it melting to my fingers right now. So that would be the final product if I got it to stick to each other. So I'll have to show you some more that I pre-made in advance with more like detail. Here's some ladybugs that I created on this one. And then I created like a marbled dragonfly, as well as, if anyone sees the kid shows Perry the Platypus, I created Perry the Platypus. That was for my brother's sake. Okay, so thank you so much for all your time. Again, I'm candidate number one. I'd also like to thank my sponsors, Northwest Communications, for all their support. It was really, thank you so much.
Candidate number two, and today I'll be doing a realistic portrait. First, I'd like to thank my sponsor, Dick's Fresh Market, for making this all possible. This painting is called Our Lady of Sorrows, otherwise known as Mother Mary. This painting is important to me because religion has always been a big part of my life and has really influenced the person who I am today. Throughout the show, I'll be showing my paintings, so look out for that. So we don't have to sit here in complete silence, an inspirational song will be playing in the background. Thank you and enjoy.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no peasant craze. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's our problem.
Kids.
Oh, sorry.
Hakuna Matata.
Oh. sponsor, Jorge Holstings for their generosity, and specifically Gwen for her kindness and support. Through COVID, I took time to learn about myself. I learned I have a love for the arts, especially dancing, where I can express myself. Tonight, I'm dedicating a dance performance to two of my biggest influencers, my grandmother and my great-grandmother. My grandmother is showing me what happiness looks like. She helps increase my self-confidence and challenges me to do what makes me feel joyful. My great-grandmother, for exemplifying a healthy lifestyle I admire. She had strength and determination, no excuses. With my grandmother's input, I chose the song Unchained Melody by the Righteous Brothers to dance to because it is a classic, a familiar, relatable song. In addition, I drew a hummingbird because my great-grandmother had a love for its elegance and its beauty. Thank you, Gigi and Grandma. I love you both very much.
Premier Complex Gymnastics. I'm involved in many things, and tonight you will see some of them in my original skit called The Jill of All and Master of None. Please enjoy. He looks familiar. Anyway, when I was trying to come up with a talent for tonight, my first thought was I can show the audience how I can interrupt anyone mid-sentence and point out a Taylor Swift reference. But then I found out that wasn't a talent, it was just rude. So I came up with a few more ideas, but I didn't think any of them would entertain an audience for 5 minutes. So this is me trying to show you a few of my ideas. But before we get started, some people might think that being a Jill of all trades is a bad thing, but I'm here to tell you that's a hoax, because why should I limit myself to just being a gymnast or a powerlifter when I find myself trying new things all the time? And my best advice for when trying new things is to have an open mind and be ready to laugh at yourself. I mean, there's many times I should have said no, like tennis in gym class. Sorry about the racket. But most of the time it turns out okay. So, the first thing I wanted to show you tonight was how fearless I was, and I thought there was no better way of doing that than a little powerlifting. This is my 225-pound deadlift. Did you see it took two of them to get it out here? Yeah, watch this. Woo! And at both of the sanctioned meets, I got steroid tested. I mean, you can see why. But I passed. But deadlifting doesn't really add up to 5 minutes of entertainment, does it? So I came up with another idea to bring my cow, 5145, out here and show her for you. But her name's Fido. We call her that because she leads like a dog, a 1,500-pound dog, but a dog nonetheless. But that also means she's a little food-driven. And I was a little nervous about some of you sneaking snacks in here. I can see you. So instead of me leading her for all to see, I'd be dragged down to row 3. And with the AC out and her distinct fragrance, I decided to leave her at the farm. But that led me to my next idea, singing, dancing, and gymnastics. And I for sure thought that was gonna be my ticket to success. But then my mom quickly reminded me that the choir teacher wanted me in the school musical for my great personality, not my singing voice. So you won't be enchanted by my singing tonight. But that left me with dance and gymnastics. And though I don't compete in dance anymore, I use it all the time in choreographing routines for gymnastics and TikTok dances. So tonight I choreographed a dance gymnastics routine for you. Ready for it?
Come on. Exteriors for all their generosity and support throughout my candidacy journey. Tonight, I have prepared for you an excerpt from President John F. Kennedy's inaugural address. When choosing my performance for tonight, I wanted something that reflected my passion for gaining knowledge and understanding, something that myself and my audience can enjoy while learning and thinking at a deeper level. I hope that you are entertained and perhaps inspired. Let both sides seek to invoke the wonders of science instead of its terrors. Together, let us explore the stars, conquer the deserts, eradicate disease, tap the ocean depths, and encourage the arts and commerce. Let both sides unite to heal in all corners of the earth. The command of Isaiah to undo the heavy burdens and let the oppressed go free. And if a beachhead of cooperation may push back the jungle of suspicion, let both sides join in creating a new endeavor. Not a new balance of power, but a new world of law, where the strong are just, the weak secure, and the peace preserved. Not all of this will be finished in the first 100 days, nor will it be finished in the first 1,000 days, nor in the life of this administration, nor even perhaps in our lifetime on this planet. But let us begin. In your hands, my fellow citizens, more than mine, will rest the final success or failure of our course. Since this country was founded, each generation of Americans has been summoned to give testimony to its national loyalty. The graves of young Americans who've answered the call to service surround the globe. Now the trumpet summons us again. Not as a call to bear arms, though arms we need. Not as a call to battle, though in battle we are. But a call to bear the burden of a long twilight struggle, year in and year out. Rejoicing in hope, patient in tribulation, a struggle against the common enemies of man, tyranny, poverty, disease, and war itself. Can we forge against these enemies a grand and global alliance, north and south, east and west, that can assure a more fruitful life for all mankind? Will you join in that historic effect? In the long history of the world, only a few generations have been granted the role of defending freedom in its hour of maximum danger. I do not shrink from this responsibility. I welcome it. I do not believe that any of us would exchange places with any other people or any other generation. The energy, the faith, the devotion which we bring to this endeavor will light our country and all who serve it. And the glow from that fire can truly light the world. And so, my fellow Americans, ask not what your country can do for you. Ask what you can do for your country. My fellow citizens of the world, ask not what America will do for you, but what together we can do for the freedom of man. Finally, whether you are citizens of America or citizens of the world, ask us here the same high standards of strength and sacrifice which we ask of you. With a good conscience, our only sure reward, with history the final judge of our deeds, let us go forth and lead the land we love, asking his blessing and his help, but knowing that here on earth, God's work must truly be our own. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I'm candidate number 8. I would first and foremost like to thank my sponsor, Wisconsin Credit Union, for all their support and generosity throughout my candidacy. Music has always been a passion of mine, so in deciding on a talent, I immediately knew I wanted to play the flute, an instrument that I've been playing for a little over 7 years. Tonight, I have chosen for you one of my favorite flute pieces to perform. Please enjoy Meursault de Concord by Gabriel Fauré. Thank you. Thank you. being here, and thank you to my sponsor, Amory Slumberland. Tonight, my talent is balloon animals, which I chose because I like to make balloon animals with my grandma. I'm also reading a book by Sandra Boysen because it's my little sister's favorite author. My talent is a recording because I have a concussion and I cannot be under the bright lights too long. So, enjoy.
For supporting me through the candidacy process. They've been a true help, and I hope they understand how much their support truly means to me. That being said, tonight I will be performing a light performance for you. I chose this talent for two distinct reasons. Reason number one, I want to have something that I actually have a lot of fun doing, and that I wanted to practice and perform tonight for you. Reason number two, the amazing talents that you've witnessed here tonight, it was only fitting to end the night with something simple, short, and fun. So please sit back, relax, and enjoy the flashing lights.